We've got to run because we've got some breaking news out of Geneva right now. Eamon Javers is there, and he joins us with that. Eamon, what's happening?
Becky, we're now getting the details from the U.S. Trade Representative of this deal between the United States and the European Union over aircraft subsidies to Boeing and Airbus. It's a five-year deal, we are told, that resolves a 16-year dispute over how each side subsidizes the aircraft companies in their sector. What we're learning now is that all tariffs that were authorized by the WTO that are related to this dispute are suspended for a total of 5 years. This will go into effect by July 11th. This agreement, we're told, is reciprocal. That is, obviously, it applies to both sides. The United States, though, will retain flexibility to reactivate the tariffs that are being suspended if the EU crosses what's called the red line and makes it difficult for U.S. producers to compete fairly. Now, in their statement about this, the United States is saying this is allowing the EU and the United States to work together to counteract China's rising influence. So the European side and the American side very much seeing a need now to work together against China. And that was a theme that we saw in the NATO summit yesterday and also in some of these EU bilateral meetings that President Biden is having in Brussels. And all of that taking place, of course, before he comes here to Geneva, Switzerland later on today, Becky. So some new news out of the trade agreement that's happening in Brussels as we speak.
So Eamon, let's just be clear about this. I want to make sure I understand this. During the Trump administration,
sure,
President Trump put duties of, I think it was $7.5 billion in tariffs that were on European goods because of a WTO ruling that said that the EU was unfairly helping Airbus and subsidizing Airbus. The EU responded by putting somewhere between $4 and $4.5 billion on tariffs back on U.S. goods because of an earlier WTO ruling that said that the United States was aiding Boeing and subsidizing Boeing. So they basically said, OK, let's call the whole thing off for 5 years. No more tariffs on either side. And we hope that we will work together and work this out.
Yeah, that's right. And they're saying that this dispute predates the Trump years, which obviously only go back 4 years. They're saying this dispute is 16 years, 16 or 17, depending on where you date it. And this now gives you a five-year window where it will be resolved. But, of course, the U.S. side seems to be retaining the ability to impose the tariffs again if they don't like what's happening in the EU. So at least a five-year window, and they say it's going into effect on July 11th. So some time to get all the ducks in a row before that actually goes into effect coming up here in just a couple of weeks now.
Eamon, thank you very much. And by the way, folks, we're watching Boeing shares up by about 0.7% right now. You want to check things out with the Dow. It's still a little bit under the fair value number, looking right now down by about 2.75, a little higher than we had been earlier.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.